Welcome to a new Ignition Gazebo tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to move our robot. We'll use the robot we built in the Build Your Own Robot tutorial. You can find the tutorial and the SDF file in the description below. Make our robot move, we will use some plugins. A plugin is a chunk of code that is compiled as a shared library and inserted into the simulation. Plugins make us control many aspects of the simulation, like world, models, etc. We will use the dev drive plugin to drive our robot. Open your SDF file and add the dev drive plugin under the vehicle below model. In the plugin tag, we define the file name, which is the file of the plugin library, and the name of the plugin, so it is DevDrive plugin. Then in the left joint tag and the right joint tag, we define the left wheel joint and the right wheel joint of your model. Then wheel separation is the distance between the two wheels of your robot, the right wheel and the left wheel. If we have a look at our links, you can see that the left wheel is at a distance 0.6 to the chassis, and for the right wheel it is negative 0.6 for the chassis, so the distance between them is 1.2 meter. The DOM publish frequency is the frequency that the robot's position is published to the DOM topic. Then we define the input topic to the dev drive plugin. Give it the name CMD Vel, which is command velocity. Topics are named buses over which nodes exchange messages. Now we will send the messages over the CMDVel topic to make our car move. First, we will launch our world. In another terminal, we will send a message to the CMDVel topic. We write IGN topic dash T for the topic, so we'll specify CMD Vel. Then dash M for the message, which message type, which is ignition twist message. And then the dash B option to publish messages. So the twist message consists of linear and angular vertices, so we'll send them. Now, if we open our simulator and press the play button, we'll find our robot moving according to the messages we send to the CMDVel topic. You can know all the options available with the IGN topic commands using dash H command. Instead of sending messages from the terminal, we will send messages using the keyboard keys. We will add two new plugins, KeyPublisher and TriggeredPublisher. KeyPublisher is an IGN GUI plugin that reads keystrokes and sends them on the default topic keyboard keypress. Open the SDF and add the plugin under the GUI tag. We define the file name and the name of the plugin. Let's test this plugin. Launch the world in one terminal. And in another terminal, we will listen to the messages published over the keyboard key press topic. IGN topic dash e for echo and then dash t and specify the name of the topic, which is keyboard key press. Now open the simulation, press the play button and try to push the keys on the keyboard. Now if you open the terminal again, you will find the data being sent on it. Next, we will map these keystrokes to twist messages and publish it over the CMD vel topic to make our robot move. To do so, we will use the triggered publisher plugin. The triggered publisher plugin publishes a user specified message on an output topic in response to an input message that matches user specified criteria. Open the SDF and add it to the end of the file before the world closing tag. The triggered publisher plugin takes the file name of the plugin and the name of the plugin triggered publisher. Then we specify the input topic and the type of the message. So the type of the message that's being sent by the keyboard plugin is integer 32 and it being published on the topic keyboard keypress. When the data being published on the topic equal to this value, which is equivalent to pressing the up key on the keyboard, the triggered publisher plugin will output a message of type in ignition messages twist on the topic CMD vel with these value linear x 0.5 and angular z 0. So our robot will move forward. Let's try this. Launch the world. Press the play button and then press the up arrow on the keyboard. You will find that the robot start moving in the forward direction with the value x equal to 0.5. We will do the same with different keys so we can control our robot to move forward, backward and rotate to the right and rotate to the left. Now we have the plugin defined 4 times. One for moving forward, x equal 0.5 and 0 in angular velocity. For the backward motion, we added negative 0.5 in the x direction. For the rotation, we made it 0 in the linear direction, negative 0.5 in the angular speed. And the same value with positive value to rotate left. Now, we can control our robot using the arrows on the keyboard. For forward direction, for left rotation and for the right rotation, and also it can move backward. Try to do the same with different keys. See you in the next tutorial.